You recording now?
I have.
Now?
Yes.
Now?
Yes.
Hello. Welcome to the John Betjeman Lectures. If you look about you, you'll see it's the very thrusting, dynamic, cutting edge of the population. I'd love to come along.
Oh, yes.
What fun we got.
Hello, and welcome to the Cheltenham Literature Festival, and in particular to this event. My name is Julia Wheeler, and I'm delighted to see so many of you here to hear about Betjeman's Churches. Famous as one of Britain's best-loved poet laureates, Sir John Betjeman had interest in many spheres. But one of his greatest passions was a love of churches. It began when, as a youngster, he went church hunting, and later he would talk about his childhood impressions of buildings, influencing how he reacted to architecture as an adult. The author and photographer Richard Sermon has built on Sir John's Collins Guide to English Parish Churches, first published in 1958. Updated and with additions, it's a beautiful guide to more than 2,500 of Britain's best churches. Candida Lysett Green is a writer and Sir John's daughter. She shares her father's love of the country, and her column in The Oldie magazine has been collected together to form one of her many books, Unwrecked England. Candida has been described by Country Life as the finest writer of our time on the English countryside. Robert Hardy is one of our best-loved actors with a long career in film and television and the theatre. He's played such varied roles as Winston Churchill, Siegfried Farnham, and Cornelius Fudge, the Minister of Magic. Today, Robert is going to read some of Sir John Betjeman's most appropriate poetry.
Green upon the flooded Avon shone the after-storm-wet sky. Quick the struggling withy branches let the leaves of autumn fly. And a star shone over Bristol, wonderfully far and high. Ringers in an oil-lit belfry, Bitton, Kelston, who shall say, smoothly practising a plain course, caverned out the dying day as their melancholy music flooded up and ebbed away. Then all Somerset was around me, and I saw the clippers ride high above the moonlit houses, triple-masted on the tide, by the tall embattled church towers of Bristol Waterside. And an undersong to branches dripping into pools and wells, out of multitudes of elm trees, over leagues of hills and dells, was the mathematic pattern of a plain course on the bells. That poem is called Bristol. I should have said that first, but I guess you got the message. This one is called A Lincolnshire Church. Greatly tremendous, the thunder hung over the width of the world. And here the green marsh was alight in a huge cloud cavern of gold. And there on a gentle eminence, topping some ash trees, a tower silver and brown in the sunlight, worn by sea wind and shower, Lincolnshire middle pointed. And around it, turning their backs, the usual sprinkle of villas, the usual woman in slacks, cigarette in her mouth, regretting Americans, stands as a wireless croons in the kitchen, manicuring her hands. Dear old, bloody old England of telegraph poles and tin, seemingly so indifferent and with so little soul to win. What sort of church, I wonder? The path is a grassy mat, and grass is drowning the headstones sloping this way and that. Cathedral glass in the windows, a roof of unsuitable slate, restored with a vengeance for certain about 1888. The door swung easily open, unlocked for these parts is on. And there on the south aisle altar is the tabernacle of God. There where the white light flickers by the white and silver veil, a wafer dipped in a wine drop, is the presence the angels hail, is God who created the heavens and the wide green marsh as well, who sings in the sky with the skylark, who calls in the evening bell, is God who prepared his coming with fruit of the earth for his food, with stone for the building his churches and trees for making his rood. There where the white light flickers, our Creator is with us yet, to be worshipped by you and the woman of the slacks and the cigarette. The great door shuts and lessens that roar of churchyard trees, and the presence of God incarnate has brought me to my knees. I acknowledge my transgressions, the well-known phrase is rolled, with thunder sailing over from the heavily clouded world, and my sin is ever before me. There in the lighted east, he stood in that lowering sunlight, an Indian Christian priest. Why he was here in Lincolnshire, I neither asked nor knew, nor whether his flock was many, nor whether his flock was few. I thought of the heaving waters that bore him from sun glare harsh, of some Indian Anglican mission to this green, enormous marsh. There where the white light flickers, here as the rains descend, the same mysterious Godhead is welcoming his friend.
About him church hunting, he actually called it church crawling. And as a child, it was a nightmare.